Welcome back to another episode with ByrdAdatto. And today, Michael, we're continuing this mini-series that we have started, working our way through the process of understanding how you as a physician should consider developing your exit plan. And we've done a whole bunch of different ones so far. We've talked about how to value it. We've talked about the things that you need to do internally to assess. But you know, Michael, let's just talk about the big picture again, making sure everybody knows where they should start.
To reset, as we've said every time, we acknowledge it's messy and it's extremely intimidating in the late stage of your career or at any point of your career to say, this is going to be when I plan to stop practicing and this is what it's going to look like. There's so many variables, but personally, financially, and even from a business perspective. And so, you know, what we are advocating for in this three-step process is just to take that step and start the process of planning. You'll be far better off. And so the three steps to building an exit plan, really it starts with the practice assessment, and that's kind of where are you now in your practice. And we always say this is beneficial even if you don't do anything further, because you at least can identify things, you know, in your business that may need to be cleaned up. The next thing is pinpointing where you want to go. And so this is kind of starting to think about your own business and personal vision for what your exit will look like and when your exit. And then the final piece is making it happen. That's building your plan. Last time we talked about the fixer-upper plan in a prior episode. And today we're going to talk about the Sensei Plan.
Yeah, and so high level, you know, context of the Sensei Plan, it really is like a lot of these things really truly aligning expectations. The reason why it's so important, this one, is conceptually this is the concept of you, a more senior physician, you want to bring on a younger doc or younger associate, and you're going to grow them into becoming a partner. And so they might join you right out of med school, but you are the teacher, they are the student. And you're going to teach them how to be a great, you know, practitioner. You're going to teach them how to be a great partner. And hopefully, more importantly, one day to run a great business. And in doing all of that, you can put better yourself and, more importantly, your practice for sale down the road when you are ready to retire. But one of the things we've learned under this one, especially in the Sensei Plan, is that setting those expectations, aligning them before they join you is essential. And we at ByrdAdatto have come up with a tool that we use call the four C's. And I think, Michael, if you can highlight the four C's so that everyone understands how important these are and why.
When you bring your associate on, you're of course going to have the dating stage, or engagement stage, the employment agreement. And so whether you go so far as to document in some form or fashion what that will look like, or you talk about it to create the alignment Brad talks about, we talk about the four C's. And that is, when you are partners, we think that the relationship is made or broken on these four things. There's cost, you know, what's it cost to get in and what are you getting for it? Compensation, during this season of life when you guys are practicing together before you sell, how are you going to pay each other? Control, how are decisions going to be made, both initially and as you transition? And then finally, the contingencies is the fourth C, and that's the dreaded D's, death, disability, and divorce. And by divorce, we mean business divorce or even personal divorce. Sometimes, depending on what stage you're in, you may want to have something in there that deals with making sure your ex-spouse doesn't get control of the practice. These are the four things that can help solidify making sure you are on the same page when you go in, because you know there could be several years before there's a transition for the ultimate sale of your practice.
Yeah, and the important thing is, you know, as Michael highlighted these four, what Michael just explained to you typically is a 60 to 90 minute lecture really to explain those four C's, but at least, you know, for our audience today, they can actually understand that those are the elements that, if at the very minimum, you need to understand exists, and there's a reason why you should have those conversations, because again, we're trying to set and align those expectations so down the road when you finally get the chance to sell, everyone knows where you're supposed to be. But I don't know if Michael, if you have any additional takeaways today.
I don't.
Excellent. Well, always good to see you. And again, always thanks for joining us.
Thanks.